Hello there, and are you all well today? I am so glad to hear that, and me, never better. And do you know why? Because we here in England are free at last. Yes, free. It's true. All COVID restrictions, lockdowns, COVID passports, wearing masks, travel restrictions, and social distancing is now over. We are free at last. People can go back to work. Kids can return to schools. You can sit in a restaurant and eat a meal without having to filter the food through a piece of cloth. How does one eat like that anyway? It's a bit awkward trying to eat fish and chips that way, isn't it? And how did this freedom come about, you ask? Especially when the rest of Europe is still experiencing, well, Nazi-like crackdowns. Just like Austria, for instance, where violators there are given heavy fines and even put in prison. Our Prime Minister here in England got caught rather blatantly ignoring the rules he was imperiously imposing on everyone else. I suppose that might be a clue. What do you think? That coupled with hundreds of thousands of people taking to the streets in loud and noisy protest also might have had something to do with the lifting of the restrictions. What do you think? So now life starts to return to normal as we become a free people once again. So, where are we going to make our freedom flight today, you ask? Well, not in England. It's still too cold. And Italy, I'm sorry, but Father Ludovic told me that they were in conditions that are just like here, freezing. I know. How does a flight from Singapore to Kuala Lumpur sound to you? Is that good? You know, it was Sky Dragon who suggested the flight. Are you there, Sky Dragon? Wake up now. Are you there? Listen up now. Remember when you asked, could you do a flight from WSSS Singapore Airport to WMKK Kuala Lumpur Airport in Malaysia? Do you remember that? So everybody, what do you think? Shall we do that? Of course we will. And I even purchased some splendid new airport sceneries for the occasion. Singapore WSSS Airport was made by Imagine Sim Designs. And Kuala Lumpur WMKK Airport was made by AA Sceneries. Both are very detailed and excellent sceneries, as you will see in a few minutes. Now, I did some research and found Singapore Airline flies that route every day. Its flight number is 106. And if you look it up on FlightAware, just put SQ106 in the search box and it will come up with all the flight history. So, are you ready, Sky Dragon? Are you ready? Then come on and join me in pre-flight and let's check the weather and make ourselves a flight plan. Well, here we are in FlightAware, and we're looking here at Singapore Airlines Flight 106. And here is the other designators that you can use in order to find this particular flight. Now, this one left gate A9 and arrived at terminal M. That's the main terminal in Kuala Lumpur. So we are going to be leaving from one of the A gates as well. Having a look at the route, you can see that it was quite an interesting flight. Here's the city-state of Singapore. And it took off, went up here, and then did this little googly up here, and then did another googly around here before coming in that way. So my presumption is that there was probably some weather, perhaps, or there were some very high traffic conditions causing the aircraft to have to go into a holding pattern. I don't know. Having a look at the flight altitude, 20,000 feet. Now, I've been looking at all the history, and it seems that all of them are all flying at 20,000 feet, so we will probably do the same thing. Looking over here, taxi time at Singapore was 17 minutes. That was quite a long, that's a long time to get there. And taxi time, once it landed, was 10 minutes. Right, let's have a look at Windy and see what it is. Well, here's windy.com for Singapore. There's Singapore, right here, see at the bottom. Wind is 010, yes, coming in fairly standard there, at 15 knots, quite a stiff breeze. Visibility 10 kilometers or more, pretty good. Clouds few at 1800. Oh, there's some towering cumulus in the area, broken at 30,000 feet. Temperature is 29 degrees, QNH 1008. So there's a little bit of low pressure over the area that is causing some inclement weather. But this is the critical bit. It's VFR, and it has been VFR for the past few hours. Looking at the runways. Well, if that's the situation and if the weather holds, then we are going to be parked right about here, just about where this aircraft is here, somewhere in this vicinity. Because this is Terminal 2, and this is where all Singapore Airlines tend to originate from. And this runway right here, 02 left, let's see if we can get that. That would make things very, very convenient then for a takeoff. And then we shouldn't have 17 minutes departure time. Looking at WMKK, this of course is Kuala Lumpur. Here you can see the main city up here, and here's the airport down below. The wind is coming straight off the water and sweeping across the ground. Currently it is VFR, but it has been some minimal conditions a couple of hours ago. Wind is variable at the moment at 2 knots, visibility 10 kilometers or more. Few clouds at 1,800 feet. Temperature is 30 degrees. Oh, well, we're certainly going to have the air conditioning on today. QNH 1007, which, of course, is still a low-pressure area over the region. Looking at the runways, well, if the weather is coming in, the wind is coming in that direction, there's no telling which one of the runways we're going to be assigned. So we will just have to see what air traffic control give us when we come in. All right, let's go to Sim Brief and let's make ourselves a flight plan. We're Ryanair, we're 186, we're departing WSSS, and we are going to WMKK. And the alternate is back at Singapore. Well, well. There's our airframe. Cruise profile 6. There's our registration. It says the scheduled flight time is 1 hour 10 minutes. Departure is runway 02 left. That's what we wanted. 32 right is the arrival runway they're predicting. Passengers, well, we are full. And we do have all kinds of champagne and caviar. We will put in here the same flight altitude as the previous ones. And there is the routing. Looking down below, here's the flight. Ah, interesting. Goes over here, then swings out over the water, comes back in to make an approach right there. Well, that'll be interesting. Certainly, it's not going to be straightforward as we think. Even though the distance between the two points is not that far, it looks like it may not be as easy as it looks. Well, Sky Dragon, it looks like you picked a flight that would be rather interesting. Anyway, we'll save that, generate the flight plan. Let's see what we get. And here we are. Flight level 200, airtime 44 minutes. There's the block fuel. That's to get us there and come back. There's the routing. No remarks. All right, having a look down now below. Here is our flight identification. Right here, that indicates the flight level that we'll be going to fly at. There is the flight routing. And that is our alternate right there. We are going to need to know that we are cost index 6. There's the average wind. We will need to know that. We're going to need to make sure that we have that much fuel in. And here are our reserves. And there's the trip and taxi. No tankering recommended, it says, but we're going to be, if we have to abort and go back to our originating airport, well then, we're tankering, aren't we? And here's the route ID. Now this is what I will put in the description box below. And here's the wind information for our trip. At flight level 200, there's the wind and the speed. There's the wind and speed at 15,000, and there's the wind and speed at 10,000. Well, there is a little bit of a weather front down below, but that should not interfere with us, I don't think. So hopefully we'll be all right. Ah, but here's the information that's going to make things interesting. Here's the flight level 180. And you see this? We are going to be bucking headwinds all the way in. So that's going to make things rather interesting. But fortunately, if you see the tail feathers on the arrows, they're not as strong as the flight that we took last week, for instance. So perhaps it won't be too bad. And here's the profile, the flight profile. Starting out from Singapore, straightforward climb, straightforward flight at 20,000 feet, and then descent in there. Doesn't look like there's going to be anything that's going to cause a problem. So, Sky Dragon, got it all down? You have all the information, made all your notes? Good. Then let's go into Navigraph charts and make our charts up there, shall we? Well, here we are in Navigraph, so I'm going to click on flights, new flight from SimBrief, and there it is. There's the one that we just made, and there's the entire route. So let's click on here, open up the charts list. We're going to need airport info, so I'm going to pin that at the bottom. We're going to need to know the parking bays. I'll pin that. And the parking bay coordinates right there. Here's what the parking bays look like. Let me just rotate this. We are going to be right around here, somewhere in this vicinity of these. Oh, Terminal 3, not Terminal 2, it's Terminal 3 that we'll be at. And this is the runway that we're proposing to take off from. So I'm hoping that we'll be somewhere around A15 for our departure. We'll be departing on the MASBO 2 East. So this is the route for departure. So I'll pin that to the bottom down here as well. Now, having a look at our destination, we're going to need the airport right there. We're going to need to know the parking stands, the main airport, and here are all the parking stands. This is the main terminal, so we'll be coming in on one of these, somewhere in this vicinity. And it says we're going to be using the GUPTA 1 Juliet approach. An interesting approach there, what don't you think? Anyway, I'll pin that to the bottom. It says we're coming in on runway 32 right. So let me go down here and find 32 right. Here we go. ILS localizer runway 32 right. Pin that. Let's have the overlay. And looking at this, looks like Mokta is the initial fix, so need to remember that. And here is the runway that we'll be coming in on. Okay, let's go down here and do the approaches. So if we're coming in on ILS runway 32 right, and using the GUPTA 1 Juliet. So ILS runway right, pin that. And let's go to final. And there we have our route all marked out. So come around, go to there, intercept the final and come in at that point. So that's our flight plan. So if you're ready, then let's go on into Ryanair 186 and get ourselves with the air conditioning on. Oh, there you are, Sky Dragon. Come on in, take your seat. Don't forget, buckle up and let's get ourselves assorted here. Now, this is some beautiful new scenery that I just got. This is Singapore Airport that I'm at. And this was done by Imagine Sim Designs. And they have pulled out all the stops. Now, I've got the external three screens at full 4K. And I'm showing 20 frames per second, with all of this detail. And I've got Shell oil refueling trucks. I've got vehicles scurrying about. I have vehicles over there. The detail is absolutely exquisite. And the one thing that I'm somewhat concerned about, I'm not sure if this is going to affect us, but I'm looking at all of these shadows that are floating around. These are birds just above. So I'm hoping that we're not going to have a bird strike. And I understand that Singapore does have a lot of birds in its vicinity. So anything could happen. Okay then. Well, since we're all set and ready to go, I'm at gate stand A15. Stand A15. And that's in the Terminal 3 area. And we're just a little bit away from runway 02 left, which I'm hoping is going to be the active runway for when we want to depart. So, are you ready? Then let's get ourselves going. All right, first thing we do, we turn on the power, make sure that we've got enough voltage up here, and then let's turn on the fuel pumps and we start the APU. Now you remember the APU is a small engine that's in the tail of the aircraft, and it's going to provide some very important things for us today. It's going to provide a generator for 115 volts. And more importantly, given that it is high temperature here, we are going to get the air conditioning running, and it will power the air conditioning for us. Yes, of course, we could always plug into the ground and have one of those things come up and plug us in, but Ryanair would have to pay for that, and which means that they would have to raise the prices for the tickets. And that's how Ryanair makes everything look so cheap. Ah, we're coming up, there we are. We now have 115 volts. So I'm going to turn on the IRS to get the GPS working. I'm going to turn on the galley, turn on the emergency exit lights, no smoking, fasten seat belts, and let's see. I wonder what these cabin crew is doing at the moment. Oh well. It looks like a lot of fun that they're having back there, but oh well. Right, I'll turn on the left and the right window heat. I'll turn on the probe. I know people don't do that until later, but I always do it up front. Hydraulic pumps are on. The lights here indicate that the forward service hatch is open and the equipment stairs are down. And people, our self-loading cargo is getting ready to come on. Then over here, I'm going to turn on the APU bleed. This is for the air conditioning now. And listen. Do you hear that rush of air? That's the air conditioning coming in. And we control all of that from up here. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the steady light down here. Right. That lets the ground crew know that there are people in here and that we are getting ourselves ready. Now, I did go and I have checked the fuel. The fuel is in. I checked the tires. I made sure the windows were all clean. Aren't you impressed, Sky Dragon? Good. All right. Now, the next thing we need to do, we've got all of this set, Now we need to program the FMC. And we are at WSSS, so WSSS. We are at gate A15. I'm going to put it in, see if it comes up, A15. And it did. So let's check this, because we want to make sure that we have the proper parking bay coordinates. So A15 should be, according to this, 12100, and 103589. 103589. That is correct. So I'm going to put that in. And now our GPS is all set up. Now go to the route. We are starting out at WSSS. And we're going to go to WMKK. We are Ryanair, RYR, and we are 186. Now I'll go to the next page, and this is where we put in the flight route. We're going to go direct to MASBO, so we'll put in MASBO. And then we take the Alpha 457, so Alpha 457, and that will take us to GUPTA. GUPTA. And that is our route. Easy. And then we'll go into fix and put in our destination fix, which of course is WMKK. And we need a 4-mile circle, a 10-mile circle, and a 30-mile circle. Go to descent, go to forecast, transition level in this region in Malaysia is flight level 130. So I'll put 130 in for transition level. And then we need the wind and speed for these three flight levels. QNH at our destination is 1007. 1007. At 20,000 feet, it is 245 at 13. 245 at 13. At 150, it is 292 at 18, 292 at 18, and at 10,000 feet, it is 299 at 15, so 299 at 15, and then we execute that, go to departures, and here we are now going to check to see which runways are in use. And 02 left is in use. So we will put 02 left in here. And our departure is the MASBO 2 Echo. So go look now here. There's the MASBO 2 Echo. Put that in. Execute. Go to arrivals. And we're planning to come in on runway 32 right. So I'll do ILS runway 32 right. And coming in on the GUPTA 1 Juliet. So that would be this one. And as for transitions, we'll leave that for the moment. Now I'm going to go to legs. Now I'm going to switch over to flight plan. And I'm going to have a look on here to see how the flight plan looked. I'm going to step through it. There's our departure routes. SATCA, MASBO, GUPTA, and coming in. So far, so good. Making the swing, there's Saldi. And I'll just join that up. And that brings us right in onto the runway. You see this? How it curves around, brings us round down to Saldi, Mokta, and then into the final runway. Good. We have a route that is working. So I'm going to put the weather on here. Data, can I do yours, Sky Dragon? I'll do terrain for yours. All right. Now I'm going to turn the yaw damper on and let's see if the flight continuity light it went out. And I'm going to turn the anti-skid, the auto brake, to RTO. And we're looking good. Everything is looking good so far. 1008. There we go. Now I'm going to set the decision height, and that I'm going to be putting into this. The decision height at our destination is 300. So turn this up until we get to 300. And according to the charts, if we have to do a missed approach or something goes pear-shaped, then we will climb to 5,500 feet and try it again. Okay. All right, our passengers are all on board, so we'll bring up the stairs and close the door. And let's get our clearance to taxi to the active. We're going to be departing to the north.
Singapore Ground, Ryanair 186 with Oscar, request taxi for takeoff north departure. Ryanair 186, taxi to and hold short of runway 2 left using taxiway Whiskey Alpha, Whiskey Papa, Sierra Charlie 1, contact tower on 118.6 when ready. Taxiing hold short runway 2 left using taxiway Whiskey Alpha, Whiskey Papa, Sierra Charlie 1, Ryanair 186.
Well, we have our clearance, we know where we're going, and now we just need to make sure everything is checked. Last thing we want to do now is go into route and we'll perform the initialization. Now the fuel today, the reserves are 3,063, the trip and taxi is 2,340, which comes to 5,403. Or 5.4, so 5.4, and the reserves 3.1. Double click that and it will calculate everything here. Cost index is 6. Our cruising altitude is 200, flight level 200. The cruise wind is 264 at 13, so 264 and 13. Transition altitude, now this is different from the transition level. The transition altitude here is 11,000 feet, so we'll put that in, execute, N1 limit. Oh, 28 degrees here, oh my goodness me. 28 degrees. Now, while we may be priding ourselves of being in 28 degrees in Singapore, and in Britain right now, today is only 5 degrees, but my friend down in Perth, Australia, tells me they've been having 40 degrees. Oh my goodness me. All right. take off, we're going to go flaps 10. Double click that to get the center of gravity and the trim. And the click on each of these will give us the V1, the rotation, and the V2 speed of 145. Now, since we're departing on runway 2 left, it says here that we need to have 23 degrees in our course heading. So I'll put 23 degrees in this. Shall I do yours? Okay. And 23 over here. And we'll be going to 20,000 feet for our cruise today. Up here, I'm going to put 20,000 feet in the pressurization, and the landing airport elevation is 69 feet, so I'm going to put 50 in here for our landing altitude. The Mach is 145. All right, we have things set up, so flight directors on. And let's check the VNAV and the LNAV. We have two green lights. We have a flight plan. That's good. I believe we're just about ready. Okay, now let's get ourselves done. The fuel is all in and checked. Windows all locked and checked. Seatbelt signs are on. Door lights are out. Check. MCP is programmed and done. Takeoff thrust levers, all the rest is done. Pre-flight is done. Rudder aileron trim is checked. Taxi aircraft feet. Well, we will swing our nose to the right and our tail to the left because we need to go out in that direction. So nose to the right, tail to the left. Anti-collision light is now on. Okay, crew, we are getting ready to move, so please put the passengers in their place quietly. So now we're ready to start, so let's contact the ground and ask them to give us a pushback. And we want the standard nose to the right, 90 degrees. Are you ready? Are you all secure? All good? All right. Okay. In that case, then, let's start.
Go ahead. We've been cleared for pushback and start. They want the tail to our left.
Roger that. Ready to push. Tail to the left. Park brakes off.
Parking brake is off.
Brakes released.
Now, which engine shall we start with today? What would you prefer? Number one? Number two? Got to go with number one? Okay, then I'll switch to engine number one.
Brakes released. Here we go.
Air conditioning is off. We're starting to move out, so I'm now going to switch engine number one on. The start valve has opened. The N2 is starting to climb. When this gets to 24, then I'll introduce the fuel. Climbing very nicely. And there it is, 24. Now I'm looking for the engine gas temperature to rise. Good, it is. I'm going to look for the low oil pressure light to go out. There it has. We're getting a good start. You should be able to hear the engines in a moment. There they are. They've kicked in. I'm going to be looking up here for 115 volts to tell us that we have engine. There it is. Now I'm switching to engine number two for a start. The start valve has opened. Here the N2 is rising. When this gets to 24, I'll be bringing in the fuel. And it's coming up. set. And the
brake set.
Gas temperature is rising nicely. I'm going to look for the low oil pressure light to go out. And it did. We're getting a good start.
All right, steering pin is disconnected. Watch for the slip release from guidance on your left. Have a good flight.
Thank you very much indeed. Making one small adjustment there, going to flaps 10. The flaps indicator is working. And we have 115 volts on engine number 2. We're now ready to switch to the main engines for our power. We'll turn on the air conditioning again, turn off the APU bleed, and turn off the APU. Now we'll turn on the runway taxi lights, and we will need to go down here and out over there to the end of the runway. So, everything's looked good so far. Right, I've got the map working here now, so you'll be able to see the map down below as to where we're going. Generators are on, probe heat is on, anti-ice not required. Isolation valve is correct, engine start levers idle, detent, flight deck door is locked, recall is checked, flight controls checked, flaps green light, stabilizer trim is correct, 4.7, auto brake is RTO, speed brake lever down and detent, ground equipment is clear. We are ready now to taxi to the active. Right. Let's do a quick check and make sure nothing's coming. I can see an aircraft over there that is coming in to land. Right, we should be all right. So give a little bit of juice to get ourselves motion here. And the kamikazes are already loitering with intent. Look at that one over there. Go on, get out of it. Okay. Now we can go into here and go down to the active runway. I did some calibration of my tiller, so it seems like it's working a little bit better. And here's the aircraft coming into land.
Pacifica 8777, taxi to north parking. Pacifica 8777.
So we'll go up here to the whole short line. There it is. Look at that.
Echo Papa Alpha 7 Lima Niger. Taxi into general aviation parking via taxiway. Echo 8 Echo Papa Alpha 7 Lima Niger.
Okay. 8777. Put the brake on. Here's where I'm going to contact the tower.
Orbit 1246, turn next taxiway.
And request clearance.
Singapore Tower, Ryanair 186, Lydia, runway 2 left, departure to the north. Ryanair 186, hold short, runway 2 left, traffic is Airbus A321 on the runway.
Roger.
Hold short, runway 2 left.
I'm going to turn the position strobe on. I'm getting my lights all on in readiness. Engine start switches are briefing, review bleeds are on, engine start switches continuous, cabin is secure.
Orbit 1246, turn next taxiway.
So we are ready to go, and I am starting the clock. Oh, we have another one coming into land.
Orbit 1246, contact ground on 121.725.
121.725, orbit
another one coming in. We'll have to wait until this clears the runway before we can get ourselves started. There he is. Do you see him? And going into there, look at that. Made itself a, that's a good landing. Of course, we are just as good.
Orbit 5643, exit runway when able.
Well, I hope that we got cleared to depart before another one comes in. Well, it's turning off the runway now, so we should get our clearance. Nothing coming.
Orbit 5643, turn next taxiway. Orbit 5643, contact ground on 121.725. Ryanair 186, cleared for takeoff, runway 2 left. Departure to the north approved. Cleared for takeoff, runway 2 left, Ryanair 186.
We are cleared to takeoff. But just check, make sure nothing's coming. We do want to make sure that we've got the runway is clear. It is our responsibility. And make our turn. We have power, N1, and toga button is pushed. seatbelt signs off and let people go for walkabouts as they want. We'll do a quick check here. Engine bleeds are on, packs are auto check, landing gear up, no lights, and flaps are up, good, no lights, altimeter set both. And we're on our way. Good. Now the localizer and our destination is 109.1, which you're in. The final is 326. So I'll put 326 in here for our final course. And I'll do yours too, Sky Dragon. All right. Okay, we're on our way. All right, Sky Dragon, we made a good takeoff there. No problems. Birds did not interfere with us. And we do have some weather in the area. But then again, this is at the tail end of the rainy season, but there'll still be some very unpredictable weather conditions ahead. But we will do fine. Now, I know you're not old enough for champagne, but we do have other drinks back there that you can have with some of that fine beluga caviar that we have on board. And then when we're on our descent and approaching to Kuala Lumpur, I'll give you a yell and then have you come back up into the cabin. How's that? Okay? All right. See you in a little bit. because that's the one that we want. So, are you ready? Are you set? And then,
right,
adjust the seats and get ourselves in position. The frame rate at the minute with all of this active sky weather is 34, 35 frames per second. So we're doing well on frame rate out there. And we'll find out in a moment just how good the scenery is at Kuala Lumpur that I got. And that was done by AA Sceneries, I believe. Here we go, we're now making our turn. Seven. Okay, we are on course.
Lumpur Tower, runway 186 is 30 miles southeast with Mike to land. Runway 186, Lumpur Tower, make straight in runway 32 right, altimeter 1008.
Right, I've adjusted it to 1008. We are given our clearance to land on runway 32 right. So everything is looking good. So now I'm going to need to slow up a little bit, so I'm going to put on flaps one. Flaps are in transit. I don't have the runway in sight yet, but we are not too far off.
World travel minor 177, clear to land runway 32 right. Clear to land runway 32 right.
Now going to flaps
two.
We are 24 DME miles away. Now the airport is out there somewhere, but we're on course, we're on track. I've got the profile for landing over on your side there, so you can see it on your screen. Going to flaps five. And now we're 21 DME miles to landing. Are starting to break up a little bit, so I'm hoping we'll see the airport shortly. And I have the airport in sight. The airport is in sight. That's good. Okay. Right. Crew, secure for landing. And recall is check, auto brake check, landing briefing is correct, engine start switch is continuous, check, flaps down, green lights, and I'm now going to put the heading on to our final approach, which is 326.
World travel minor 177, exit runway when able.
the runway ahead. Speed is 170.171.
World travel minus 177. Turn next taxi.
And we have flaps 5. Looking good so far, but that is a big airport.
2749 ready for IFR departure. Runway 32 right. Over 274 minus on shore. Runway 32 right. Traffic is Airbus A321 on the runway. World travel minus 177. Contact ground on 121.65.
We have a little bit of a crosswind coming in, so it's not going to be a straightforward. It's only a 6-knot crosswind, but it can be interesting. All right, resetting the MCP to 5500 in case of a missed approach. We're 12 miles from touchdown. Everything is looking good. I'm now acquiring the glide slope.
243, exit runway when able.
And you can see us acquiring the glide slope on yours. The runway is in sight. We're doing well.
World travel 243, turn next taxiway.
Going to go to flaps 10. Okay, here we go then. Steering tiller, it's a lot better control. I'm not wafting as I was before. Part of the maintenance. Okay, we go down here until we get to the
orbit 2531, exit runway when able.
Looked at the flight aware, it just said that it was parked at the main terminal. So we're going to
6 minor clear to land runway 32 right, follow the Airbus A321 on the runway.
So we'll find ourselves a place to park.
32 right, Pacifica 6 minor, orbit 253.
I hope that one over there is not planning to be a kamikaze. That would be very unfortunate. But this is the main terminal building here on the right. So it's this one that we take, I think. This is the F1. This is the Foxtrot. Good. Underneath the taxiways. Very, very detailed. Really, really very good. To the other side, and we'll make our turning in on the Tango 5. That should be this one coming up. Right, I'm going to turn on the APU, get it set and ready. This is the Alpha we need the Alpha 2, which is this one. Okay. All right, so we'll do this. Coming in on Alpha 2, and markers for 737 and stop. Okay, brake on, engines off, lights off. Okay, your damper is off. And starting the switches, fasten seat belts are off. Stairs and doors are opening. Window heat is off. Probe is off. Bumps are off. Right, and TCAS is off, fuel is off, APU is off, and battery is off. Shutdown is complete. Well, Sky Dragon, we made it. What do you think of that? We did all right, didn't we? We're here at Alpha 2, which is in the main terminal building at Kuala Lumpur. We made it. So, this was your request. I hope that we did all right. And by the way, I do appreciate the short flights. There's nothing more boring than flying a big modern jet. They have everything is automated, and the pilot has nothing to do except take off and land if they're lucky. So I always appreciate short flights. Thank you for that. Now we will let everybody go and enjoy Kuala Lumpur, get some good fresh fruit, enjoy the scenery, enjoy the warmth, and I will see everybody next week on another flight of Ryanair 186. Bye, everybody.